All this week, we've been bringing you stories of some of the hundreds of thousands of Vietnamese who escaped to the United States to build new futures in a new land.
Well, among the refugees, a face that you will no doubt recognize, but you probably haven't heard her whole story until now.
Okay, Thuy in three, two.
Thuy Vu is a well-known, award-winning journalist.
And joining us now to this
host of the venerated KQED newsroom.
I'm so proud of what we've been doing on this show.
It's hard to imagine 40 years ago, a violent and chaotic moment in history would change her life so dramatically.
Thousands of people were roaming Da Nang airfield.
It all began in Vietnam.
I look back and I think, what an incredible journey, and it has been quite a journey.
Her parents married and settled in Saigon, where they raised a family.
I was the second to the youngest of eight kids.
Angry men left behind.
In 1975, as the Viet Cong invaded the South, fear and panic gripped the streets. When Saigon fell, Thuy and her family had to flee.
I didn't really realize that we would probably never return to Vietnam to live ever again. I didn't realize we were losing our country and our home.
To get out, the family had to split up. Half went by cargo ship, the other half by plane. On the boat, Thuy and several siblings. On the plane, her mother, who made sure to bring one son.
She said she wanted to have at least one boy with her so that if we all died at sea, she would have a son to carry on the family name. And that breaks my heart.
It was a perilous journey by sea. An American ship eventually rescued them. They were brought to a refugee camp in Guam and housed in a tent city. A few months later,
they discovered the other half of my family had landed in Fort Chaffee, Arkansas, at a relocation center there.
A Lutheran church group in Duluth, Minnesota, sponsored the family.
Going from Vietnam to Duluth, Minnesota, wow, quite a shock.
It was really cold.
It was a struggle. My parents, you know, did menial jobs. My mom worked in a garment factory. My dad worked in a pizza factory.
After a few years, Thuy's mom decided they'd move to sunny California, where the schools were great.
It dawned on my mom that, and my dad, that really the only way to better our lives is to make sure to get the kids a good education.
The family ended up in Silicon Valley, where chips replaced crops, and motherboards and microprocessors ruled. Her parents worked on the assembly lines, as did Thuy during the summer.
I would be putting in the transistors and the capacitors.
She graduated from Cal with honors in rhetoric. At Berkeley, Thuy fell in love with journalism. She anchored a morning newscast on the campus radio station.
And I did that twice a week, and I loved it.
There's a bag of sweet treats.
The young college grad landed numerous local gigs in broadcast news. She worked at KPIX 5 as an on-air journalist. Thuy won a major award for her report on the continuing impact of Agent Orange in Vietnam.
Welcome to KQED Newsroom.
As for her incredible journey to the United States, Thuy marvels at what she calls her life lessons.
Tenacity, hope, a sense of hard work, and a sense of sticking it out, those are things that will pull you through a lot of really tough situations.
Lessons she hopes to pass on to her own daughter. No doubt an amazing story. We have a lot more on the end of the war, the refugees, and the lives of Vietnamese Americans right here in the Bay Area. Coming up after this newscast in our special, The Fall of Saigon, 40 years later.